Planet Earth. 6.6 sextillion tons of mass floating through space. The surface of which is covered in stunning and awe-inspiring features. These features, such as mountains, valleys, and plains, are formed over hundreds, thousands, and even millions of years.
Boring! But we don't care about any of that nonsense. We are going to look at Earth's extreme forces that rapidly change our planet's surface. We will investigate volcanic eruptions, earthquakes, and landslides that occur very rapidly. These extreme forces can completely change the surface within just hours and days.
These slow and rapid changes create different landforms because of natural forces that happen both above and below the ground.
Earth is made up of three basic layers: the crust, the mantle, and the core.
Instead of just being one giant layer, Earth's crust and upper mantle move very slowly together as gigantic pieces called tectonic plates.
Tectonic!
This slow movement is caused by molten rock beneath, sliding past the enormous plates above.
This movement might be slow, but the movement of such massive pieces of our planet causes extreme events to occur.
Two of the three large forces that change the Earth rapidly, volcanoes and earthquakes, begin below the surface of the Earth along boundaries where tectonic plates collide. The third large force, landslides, occur above the surface.
Eruptions and earthquakes are nature's pressure valves. Tremendous heat from within the Earth causes all rock and matter to become magma. As is the rule with extreme heat, gases begin to build within the Earth, forming bubbles in the magma. These bubbles crowd in with all the magma, taking up space in an area where there is very little room left. When too many gas bubbles form and all the room is gone, we end up with
extreme conditions. These bubbles fight their way through the magma and the
tectonic
place like a mosh pit. Once they find their way through a crack, volcanic eruptions! The extreme
action
strength of this churning magma causes the huge
tectonic
plates to shift and move. But when the titanic plates grate against, smash into, or collide with another plate, we get earthquakes.
In all seriousness, these events often happen on a very large scale.
Very large!
And can have devastating,
destructive,
and sometimes deadly effects.
Many such events have happened here on American soil.
Thank you.
Mount St. Helens, an active strato volcano in Washington State, vigorously erupted for 9 straight hours.
Ash was found as far east as New York City. Air pollution monitors detected ash 2 weeks later that had traveled all the way around the globe. We actually had family living in Eastern Washington at the time of the eruption, and they were able to collect this jar of ash that fell from the sky on them just like snow. So this here is actual Mount St. Helens ash.
Ash?
Yeah, it is.
That's a lot of ash.
I know.
The Pacific Ocean, planet Earth's largest ocean, reaching a depth of 35,797 feet. It is also the largest of our world's oceans at 63.8 million square miles. Home to abundant sea life, the deepest place on Earth, the Mariana Trench, as well as the tallest mountain on Earth, Mauna Kea, which reaches a height that is 4,445 feet taller than Mount Everest.
It's also home to the most extreme, place on our planet, the Ring of Fire. Numerous volcanoes and earthquakes occur along this Pacific Ring of Fire.
Volcanoes erupt when magma reaches the surface as lava. Lava flows down the sides of the volcano and hardens.
Ash, cinders, and gases are also released.
Huh. The largest volcanoes on Earth, called shield volcanoes, release slow, continuous lava flows to create wide volcanic mountains.
Some volcanoes erupt violently with pyroclastic flows that destroy landscapes and lives in its path.
Some volcanoes form on the ocean floor over hot spots, and after repeated eruptions, build up enough lava to form islands like the Hawaiian Islands.
Volcanoes have two major effects on the surface of our Earth.
Volcanoes can both destroy
and create a landscape.
When volcanic rock erodes after many years, soil often collects in the crevices, allowing plant growth to take root and animal life to develop. Many volcanoes are no longer active, such as those that form the Davis Mountains in Texas, but serve as reminders of how the very forces that destroy are the same forces that create new land and new life.
What?
The tectonic plates.
Tectonic!
That make up the surface of the Earth move and slide against each other and sometimes get stuck due to the rough edges of the blocks.
Pressure begins to build more and more as the plates fight and wrestle with each other in their desire to keep moving. When too much pressure builds up, the plates finally slip, releasing all that pressure in the form of extreme shaking vibrations called earthquakes that radiate outward at anywhere from 11,000 to 18,000 miles per hour.
These shaking vibrations are called seismic waves.
Seismic waves can be felt many miles away. They both stretch rock back and forth and shake it side to side. Together,
These vibrations, which ripple out from the epicenter like ripples in a pond, can cause massive damage to landforms, buildings, roads, bridges, power lines, and can often take the lives of those people and animals caught in the collapses.
Sometimes earthquakes occur on the ocean floor, causing enormous waves called tsunamis that crash into coastal areas, destroying and flooding miles inland.
Landslides occur where the earth collapses suddenly. This can be caused by seismic vibrations or when the earth gets too saturated with water and the land slumps downward. Landslides and other inevitable rapid changes to Earth's surface have led to the research and creation of buildings, roads, and bridges that can withstand these forces of nature.
On a far more serious note, these extreme events can and have caused significant damage. Many people lose their lives in these circumstances, and none of these events are a joke to the people and families affected by rapid changes in the Earth's surface.